Attractions likes to focus on the development of the agricultural industry. That's why this week we're traveling north of Tufnell, Saskatchewan to see how fencing pioneers paved the way for how fences are built today. Fencing first became mandatory in Saskatchewan in 1889 with the exception of several community members that said, hey, hold on a minute, if you let the neighbors put all their fences up first, we'll only have to put one piece along the roadway. The same community members, just in a different generation, still exist today. You can see their cattle out all over the damn country and they demand a tax break from the RM because their livestock mow and fertilize the ditch for free. Some Saskatchewan fences are built by professionals requiring a large amount of capital investment, and other Saskatchewan fences are built with whatever trees you can find in the bush and some old wire. They both serve the same purpose with properly trained cattle. Big Mustache Al ventures north of Tufnell, Saskatchewan, found an innovative way to use one of his 300 pallets to allow calves to stay inside of the pasture and still harvest water from the local ditch to fill his dugout. Fencing pioneers have developed several types of splicing techniques. Here, we see the I do not know how to splice high tensile wire splice. As we see here, it is referred to as the I really don't give a shit anymore splice because the elk, moose, and deer are just gonna mow it down again anyways. The holy shit, the cattle are in the stackyard splice. Get it fixed and get those bitches back in the pasture before we lose all our feed. Another great fencing pioneer between Tufnell and Laco, Saskatchewan, shocked the community when he ordered a bundle of posts that were not pressure treated and protected them from the weather by covering them with durable boots. Although he did not know it at the time, he was creating a forever landmark here in the Laco area that is now called Boot Corner and has become a tourist attraction where you can come and nail your shoes to the posts. Boot Corner is also an integral landmark in the directions to the community pasture or to Margo. Many fencing pioneers find themselves restricted on time, so have to temporarily turn their permanent fencing project into an electric fence project. Temporarily turns it to 10 years. Another great fencing pioneer south of Margo, Saskatchewan, changed the way we look at the gate brace post and the corner brace post when he discovered that CN and CP Rail provide these posts for free as long as you collect them between the hours of 1 and 4 a.m. Some fences in these parts experience something we refer to as the Saskatchewan sag, where you're not sure if the posts are holding up the wire or the wire is holding up the posts, but it's still a team effort to keep the cows in. In order to offset climate change, some of the most elite pioneers in fencing north of Tufnell, Saskatchewan have switched to organic fencing. Not only does organic fencing not require the plowing down of bush, but it also means that you could pull the staple once the tree has absorbed the wire and either use it on your next fence or sell it to a local steel recycler. Pernoweski Steel Recycling will pay up to 10 cents a pound for used fencing staples and provide free pickup. Contracts are only paid for in full once steel has been delivered to Portage la Prairie. As you can see, organic fences are highly effective and have a very low impact on the environment. From time to time, due to excessive tension on wires, a corner brace may start to pull inwards. It is important to anchor all corner braces as pictured here. And although you do not commonly see them in Saskatchewan, buffalo fencing is highly involved and typically resembles a penitentiary. It stands to reason, because Quick Dick can assure you, you do not want one of those fuckers taking a run at you. Wind fences start new on all entrepreneurial Saskatchewan agricultural operations. Saskatchewan wind fence will reach a midpoint in its life where it is slightly weathered, still durable, and provides ample shelter. The third stage of a wind fence's life is when it becomes old, rotten, and starts to lean in and poses a danger that cattle might be pierced by it. Fun fact about the Saskatchewan wind fence, retiring ranchers in Saskatchewan have started selling the boards off of them for 8 times the amount they paid for them back in 1963 to the rustic furniture business. Somebody show Quick Dick a broker that can make you that kind of return on your investment. Some fencing pioneers near Foam Lake, Saskatchewan have switched to page wire on wild boar operations. It's highly intensive and, oh, we've been joined by Justin Trudeau today. Mr. Trudeau, hi. Page wire fencing is also used to house llamas, but they're very camera shy and refuse to appear on Quick Dick today. This has been Spotlight on Fencing Pioneers. This is Quick Dick McDick signing off, reminding you to keep your fence posts and your old lady pounded. We'll catch you next time.